Ètò ìfilọ́lẹ̀ ibùdó àgbáyé fún ìtàn àṣà àti ìṣe Yorùbá tí a ń ṣe lónìí kìí ṣe fún Yorùbá nìkan. Gbogbo èrò wa àtàníyàn wa ni pé kí a máa rérò níbí láti gbogbo àgbáyé kí wọ́n máa wá kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ níbí nípa gbogbo ṣẹ̀ǹbáyé Yorùbá. Nítorí náà, Gẹ̀ẹ́sì lèmi máa fi sọ̀rọ̀ mi lónìí o, kí gbogbo àwọn tí wọ́n máa bá wa kàn tán máa gbá kan gbogbo ìfilọ́lẹ̀ yìí sí afẹ́fẹ́, kí wọ́n lè gbé káàkiri àgbáyé, kí gbogbo àwọn èèyàn gbọ́ kán dẹ̀ mọ̀ pé Yorùbá èyí tá a fẹ́ ṣe ń bí o, pé Yorùbá gbégbèsẹ̀ kan tí gbogbo àgbáyé ní láti gbọ́, tí wọ́n dẹ̀ ní láti mọ̀. Alagba Alao Adedayo and the Institute of African Studies and the Yorùbá Language Center, University of Ibadan, thank you for the very kind invitation to be here for the launching of the International Center for Yorùbá Arts and Culture, so fittingly located here in Ibadan, or your state. You have initiated a place that will give context and depth to our understanding of our past, our place and role in the present, and hopefully our preparation for the future. A place that will help tell a fuller, deeper, and richer story of a proud, creative, and colorful people, but also of the rich tapestry of cultures, races, ethnicities, and faiths of which they are a part. At a more reflective level, we will, through this repository, and the traditions embedded in the artworks and cultural artifacts, imbibe the triumphs, the challenges, the inventions, and the spiritual heritage of the Yorùbá people. We know that well before contact with the Western world, and Alaafin has made that very clear to us, the Yorùbás had a fine artistic and a fine political tradition, rendered through sculpture and architecture, using bronze, wood, stone, terracotta, and brass. Such was the quality of the work that when Leo Frobenius, the German ethnographer, came across the Ife bronze and terracotta sculpture, he was convinced that he had discovered the treasures of the mythical lost city of Atlantis. Later research proved him wrong. These were actually the works of 12th to 15th century AD Yorùbá craftsmen. But beyond and yet inherent in the splendor and beauty of the artworks and the genius of artists are the histories and stories of our people. The forced relocation of Yorùbá people by slave dealers to the Americas and the Caribbean and other unspeakable degradations and atrocities of slavery, and the ways in which Yorùbá culture adapted and survived in the dehumanizing humiliations and sufferings in those distant and hostile environments, and how here at home, Yorùbá culture also had to adapt to the onslaught of colonialism in Nigeria by the British, and in Benin and Togo by the French. In Death and the King's Horseman, a classic play by Professor Wole Soyinka, we see forces at work that try to adapt cultural practices with tragic consequences. The effort of the district officer in that play to prevent Eleshin Oba from doing his duty to accompany his Oba into the great beyond ended with the son of the Eleshin himself taking his own life. The story of how the clash of cultures with colonial overlords shaped who we are today, and to some extent, the incongruity of our institutions. So culture is not just about the past. It's neither static nor immutable. It is constantly creating and recreating. Consequently, progress is not merely determined by fidelity to tradition, but by our capacity for invention and reinvention. And this point is more relevant now than ever before, as the world itself and our nation stand at crossroads. The future of mankind is at an inflection point with COVID-19 and climate change already disrupting life as we know it, while the fourth industrial revolution requires us to adapt to technological innovation, changing at lightning speed. To cope well, we must draw strength from our cultural capital, the wealth of tangible and intangible knowledge that emanates from a society's core and enables it to cope with change. One of the tasks of scholars, of enthusiasts, and citizens interested in understanding the Yoruba heritage is to use culture as a tool for helping us discern our place in the world and to rekindle our visionary capabilities. This intent is inherent in the design and work of this center. It bears repeating that culture is not just about antiquity. It's about the contemporary age and even the age to come. This World Center will therefore serve not just as a piece or a place of memory, but a place that inspires us and fires our collective imagination, even within the dynamic context of advances in technology, ideas, and thought. But perhaps more importantly today, the work of this center should offer a base from which and a sanctuary in which we can reflect on how Yoruba culture can contribute to the tools of nation building, the building of a more inclusive, a fairer, and more just society, the bringing together as one people an ethnically and religiously diverse nation. How can the rest of the nation learn, as President Buhari observed, from the way that we Yorubas manage within our families to accommodate diverse faiths and beliefs? And in a nation dogged by abdication of high values, especially in leadership, perhaps the center might take on the task of formalizing knowledge on the concept of Omoluabi for teaching in our schools. Omoluabi, the true moral quintessence of the Yoruba race, the virtuous man or woman, the man or woman of character. Perhaps the scholars here will distill the heart of the Omoluabi ethos and reveal the attributes of trustworthiness, reliability, honesty, and forthrightness for coming generations of Nigerians. Perhaps the world needs to know that the Omoluabi is one whose word to brother and stranger alike is reliable, one who believes in the equality of all men, regardless of race or belief, and that all deserve to be treated with dignity and fairness, one who believes that the commonwealth is not to be stolen or personalized, but it is for the good of all. Given the range of its ambitions and the strength of the resources that will come here, I know that this center will locate itself in the emergent creative economy and light the fires of imagination, especially of our young people. So it might also be of use to formalize knowledge on how, for example, a Fela Anikula Kokuti used an admixture of the rhythms of the heartland and high life to create a new genre of music, Afrobeat, that has since become a global phenomenon. Today, young Nigerian artists are using local sounds to create a globally popular culture. Is there something to be learned here? Additionally, the center should offer a destination for missions of discovery by the very many Africans in diaspora who trace their origins to the Yoruba people and promote closer links between the Yoruba people in the homeland and their kith and kin in the diaspora. But more importantly, provide a crucial pillar in the global attempt to build social and economic bridges between peoples of African descent everywhere in the world. And while we're at it, you must join in the global movement to champion the return of artifacts that were plundered, looted, or illegally taken away from these shores. Indeed, the center should serve as a home for such returned items where the immediate provenance or circumstances in which the items were taken is unclear or not known. So let me again commend the architects of this initiative, led by Alagba Alao Adedayo, for the boldness and ambition of their enterprise and for the enormous self-sacrifice and patriotism that this must have entailed. We must all seize. We must all seize this moment. We must seize this moment and join in this glorious civic endeavor. And the time to do so is now. Agbajo owo lafin soya. Ajejo owo kan ogberu dori o. Be dere a ki refon ta le meji o. The time is now. Abomire o. Mo ki gbogbo yin o. Thank you.